We have to rethink that men's sexual problems can also occur in the flaccid state. And I think that's going to take a little time because providers are very insensitive to hard flaccid.
Yes.
They get the, oh God, go away, there's nothing wrong with you.
Welcome to this very special edition of UroChannel. Whenever I have complicated patients, and you know I have a lot of complicated patients, I'm looking up at the internet and I'm reading articles. And there's one name that always pops up when I read articles, and this is Professor Irwin Goldstein. And here's the man himself.
Wow.
I'm so glad.
You're in Amsterdam.
Yes.
The International Society of Medical Shockwave Therapy. An amazing medical therapy for has limited risk, lots of benefits, at least in sexual medicine circles. And so happy to be here.
Yes, you're very welcome. And I feel very honored that you are on the show.
I feel just as honored back. Thank you.
So we are going to go into detail, the nitty gritty right away.
Okay,
I'm going to explain to you guys what I'm talking to. Let's have a quick look at the anatomy. In his publication, Dr. Goldstein and co-workers propose an explanation for the hard flaccid syndrome, looking at what could possibly go wrong with the nerve wiring. Any neural signal travels through several nerves which are connected to each other. The spinal cord acts as a control center. It receives signals from the periphery and switches them to other nerves. A reflex is a signal that bypasses the brain. The spinal cord processes the impulse and sends it back for immediate action. It's one of the protective mechanisms of the body because it enables much quicker reaction times. With hard flaccid syndrome, a certain type of reflex could be pathologically activated within the spinal cord of the lumbar spine. It will permanently switch on the sympathetic nerves and cause contraction of the penis, among others. So the first thing is the pathological pelvic pudendal hypogastric reflex. You wrote about this.
For hard flaccid syndrome.
Yes.
Wow.
So what is it?
Awful condition, hard flaccid.
Absolutely.
Just amazingly nightmarish. So you have, how do you think this? You have organs and they all have connections to the brain and the brain has connections back to the organs. And you expect at some level that all the regulations are appropriate. You have the penis and it gets erect. That means the signals from the brain come down after sexual arousal and they cause the muscles to relax. The blood rushes into the penis widens and lengthens, it traps its blood, it gets hard. And then at some level, you activate the opposite nerve called the hypogastric nerve that makes the muscles contract. Then the blood can escape from the penis and the penis goes down. So you have this beautiful balance between the what's called the sympathetic system, which is the contraction, and the parasympathetic system, which is the relaxation. And life is supposed to be good that way. You can get states where there's excess parasympathetic stimulation. It's called sleep-related painful erection. Is excess parasympathetic. And I guess the mirror image opposite to sleep-related painful erection due to hyper parasympathetic activity is this awful hard flaccid condition where the sympathetic nerve is firing without permission. The penis is shriveled. It's cold. The other nerves that the sympathetic also goes to the bladder and neck, so it's really difficult to urinate. The bowel is also under sympathetic control, so it's difficult to defecate. The testicles ride high. In the scrotum, the muscles, the dartos muscles are fired. We call that lava lamp scrotum. And you live this way, and it's awful. And we don't know how to stop it. We know that something is activating that sympathetic system, but we're not smart enough quite yet to understand how this occurs in all people. We have identified triggers that are in the sort of genital area. We call that region one. In the pelvis perineum area, we call that region two. And I'm very fortunate to work with a spine surgeon. So we have identified lesions in the caudate quina. that are sending information to the preganglionic system, to the ganglia itself, and then to the postganglionic sympathetic system, which causes this horrible system. I mean, for some people, it's really a devastating, life-threatening suicide.
It is.
Problem.
And if we just stick to region one,
yeah.
Do you think it is possible to self-inflict this onto you?
Well, I think that's the vast majority of these cases.